So if you're a guy like me, and I know you're not, and that's a good thing, and the kind of guy I am is the kind of guy that wants to use his hammock all the time, no matter where I camp. So what I've got on the end, holding this end of my hammock, is called the NoGround hiking pole. It's a hiking pole, it turns into bridge hammock spreader bars, and it also works as a hammock support if you've only got one tree. And if you use two hiking poles, you could use two of these to hang your hammock if you're in the middle of a meadow. Don't bother me now, I got some laying back to do. Okay, that was me getting in the hammock and just a little close-up look at the stakes and just to see how much they moved in my soil out here, which is pretty wet today, so. But I use the Alamosa anchors, and I use the large snow anchor, which I think she calls the pretty big anchor. And then I use one extra snow anchor because they got a lot of hold. So that's holding me with no problem whatsoever. And I'm about 190 pounds. Let's take one more look at those stakes while I get in and bounce a little bit. Woo, buddy! She provides this little do not make the mistake of not screwing that back down, because the strength in these is having that screwed on. They're supposedly good for 400 pounds. That's what comes with it. That could be replaced. That goes on my continual loop right there. So this is what a continual loop looks like. It's just an Amsteel loop. And that's what goes on the end of my hammock. You do a lark's head. A lark's head is basically making a loop. All right. So where you'd have two little butterflies. Let's pretend my finger is the end of the hammock. It's like that. That's the whipping. So it would be this way. This is what we're hanging to right there. Boom. Does that make sense? Not to all of you. All right, so if I'm going out somewhere and I know I can get to one tree, say like a festival or hanging off my car or something, this is an option I could use. Or backpacking in some places I've been that I have seen before where I've stopped and went, man, this would be a great place to camp, but I couldn't hang my hammock here because there's only one tree, or the trees are too far, or there's a rock. And now, if I want, I can go back there and hang just for the sake of that. So, you know, pretty cool idea. And the great thing about this is it's multi-use. Not even to mention that you can use the pole as bridge hammock spreader bars. That is so cool, man. All right, here we're taking a look. Coming from where the lines come down, thick Amsteel lines, to a UCR, which is a utility constrictor. And it's kind of like a whoopee sling, but that cannot be like that. This knot holds this from slipping right there. Now it comes down to the Alamosa anchor. Easy enough to make this little knot right here, just a loop. That is sunk into the ground. I take one small snow stake. I'm just testing this one to go into this Amsteel loop that comes off of that top of that stake. And then the wire cable that is supplied, because I'm a bigger guy, I'm 190 pounds, I'm going out to one more stake there. I'll probably just carry these because I'm testing them, but that's basically how the staking is working at this point. What I'm looking at here is the hiking pole, but when you turn it into this, you add this little section of pole right here. You can see where I have them, a piece of blue tape in there just to mark where they are. I think it's like a 12-foot section and a 9-foot section. And this is what holds your lines. And they go out to these little truss bars to a hub right here. And there's three of them, and they're quite tight. They're very tight to give it support. There is a weight limit on this, and I think, and it's really what the pole back there will support. I'm going to refer you right now to her how-to videos because they're clear, and I'm still getting to know the system, and it's like a lot of things. It's like the first time you get your hammock. You got to put it together a few times. You got to hang it a few times. You got to get to know it,
in order to kind of memorize it. It can seem a little confusing at first, but once you watch her videos and go out and do it, you'll see that it makes sense. It's really the staking out and judging the distance of your hang that is a little bit trickier, and a little bit setting up the pole the first couple of times and figuring out your technique. I will do my own how-to once I know how to myself a lot better. But what I like about this is everything is with you. It's a little bit of extra weight with the bits and pieces. Really not that bad. I haven't weighed the whole system because I'm still experimenting with my stakes and how many it takes. What I'm gonna do now is hook a tarp up so you can see how that works.
So there we go, tarp pitched. I have the tarp, I added a little rubber knob onto that little piece right there. This that screws this on, it's called your tarp piece. And I just have my tarp, this part just resting on there. So I can still close the doors on the end. Got the tarp tied off on the tree here. Pitch down plenty tight underneath. That is my hammock gear Cuban fiber tarp with an 11-foot ridge line.
Oh, so hey guys, let's take one more look as I crawl in the hammock. And I'm interested in seeing this too, to see if this gives or bends at all. This is gonna be exciting. This is like eighth grade science class. I am getting in the hammock. I am bouncing up and down. Does it bend at all? Just keep in mind that I am getting to know this system right now too. I'm experimenting with it. I'm giving some feedback to Rafting Tigger, who is the inventor who is working on this part. So look below in the description box and you'll find all the information. Go to her Facebook page where she has her videos and information, prices and things like that, I think. And this may be something for some of you who have asked me in the past, like,
hey, Sugar, how do you rig your hammock up? You know, if you've only got one tree, or I'd like to tie it off to my car and I'm out in the field, I don't know how, what else to tie it to, or what if I was in a meadow somewhere up on a mountain bald and I want to rig my hammock because I'm very into my hammock.
And I'm very into my hammock. So now this gives me a few options that I can explore in some other places. So till then, all secure in Sector 7, woo buddy! This is something that I'm very interested in. She sent it to me and said she would like me to put it through the paces. So fair enough, there you go. All right, bye-bye now, see you later, ta-ta, good day. Number one, testing out a new hiking pole, which actually turns into bridge.